Let us pray. God, our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
receive the spirit of adoption, through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If only we suffer with Him, so that we might also be glorified with Him. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit, the divine community to which we have been
gathered by the Paschal mystery. That's why the Trinity isn't just some arcane Rubik's cube for theologians to puzzle over. It lies in the very heart of Christianity, because without it, we are not saved, not gathered into the divine life. John says in his first letter that God is love. He doesn't say that love is something that God does from time to time, or that love is one attribute of God. He said that God is love. Well, here's the thing. To say that God is love is to say that God must be a trinity of persons, because it means that there must be a lover, one who is love, and the love that they share. Now, how we begin even a tentative way to understand this, St. Augustine gave us a beautiful analogy in his great book, De Trinitate. An analogy allows us to see to some degree what will always be inadequate. But here we go anyway. Augustine points out that Scripture says we are made in the image and likeness of God. That means that we human beings, in a unique and privileged way, look somehow like the Trinity. We can expect, therefore, to find in our lives some icon or image of the Trinity. So, in his writing, Augustine begins by looking deep within himself. And when you look deep within, you find your own mind, your own memories, an opaque spiritual energy from which all your psychological and intellectual life comes from. Augustine said that the mind is able to form an image of itself, to think about itself, to see itself as distinct and other. Now, you might say that sounds kind of crazy, but no, we do it all the time. We do this when we talk to ourselves and ask questions like, why did I do that? Do you know of any other creature alive that can do that? Whenever we do this, we are looking at ourselves. In that act, there is a mind that looks, and there is an image that the mind looks at. Now, are they separate, distinct? Yes, conceptually, but aren't they also the same? Because the image of the mind came from the mind. So there is a looker, there is one who is looked at, but it's the same being. Then, says Augustine, once the mind looks at itself, it tends to fall in love with what it sees. Now, you might say to yourself, that sounds kind of strange. I don't fall in love with everything that I just see, right? Well, but, you know, religion of all sorts for centuries has stressed the fact that people need to be introspective, that they need to look inside themselves. Like, we can't even do a good act of contrition without first examining our conscience, which means examining myself and getting to know who I am little by little by doing that over the course of a lifetime. And every so often when I'm in there, bumping around, looking at my insides, I notice, wow, look at this person that's here, that God made, the physical and the spiritual part of me. And yeah, there's sin in here, I get it. But look at what God has done in creating me, in giving me the faculties of reason and physical attributes and the ability to form relationships and fall in love. And you know, if you look at it the right way, life is kind of like a poem. It's beautiful. You begin to fall in love with what you see. Well, that love, that desire, is itself the same as the mind. Not a different mind. Therefore, there is mind, self-knowledge, and self-love. That's one way that human beings can image the Trinity. There are others. Think about married couples who have children. We say that the Father and the Son look at each other and fall in love. And that the very love that exists between them is the Holy Spirit. Right? That's straight out of Thomas Aquinas. Well, what about married couples? They get married. They come together in the marital embrace in love. And it becomes so intense, so real. 9 months later, you've got to give it a name. Right? That's another way human beings can image the Trinity. So we can think of the Father as the mind of God. The Father is able from all eternity to generate and see an image of himself. The Bible calls this image the Logos, or the Word of God, or the Son. Now, are they the same? Yes. The Father knows himself in the Son. The Father then looks at himself in the Son, and the Son looks back. Each of them sees what's most perfect and beautiful and good in the other, and the two fall in love. The two of them sigh their love for each other. Their sigh is the Holy Spirit, the Holy Breath, the Holy Wind that I spoke about last week. And Archbishop Fulci used to say that. I don't know if any of you watched him when you were younger, but he used to say that the Holy Spirit is the love sigh between the Father and the Son. God is one, yet he is this community of persons. The Father is the one who gives rise to the Son. The Son is the one who is generated by the Father. The Spirit is the one who breathes forth between Father and Son. What is key here is that each of the three are themselves relationships. Augustine called them subsistent relations. So at your next cocktail party, you can pull out that $5 term and impress your friends without telling you that. What do you think about subsistent relations? Most of us think that I as a human am substantially real, that I exist physically in this realm. And of course that's true. But a whole lot of people will then say, well, a relationship is incidental, accidental, secondary to life. Well, look at the doctrine of the Trinity. It would appear that the most basic reality there is relationship, because that's who God is. Therefore, when we give ourselves in love to others, we are most ourselves. We are most alive. That's why living in the Father, Son, and Spirit is to be most fully alive. Let us stand up together and confess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of all, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial of the Father, through whom all things Spirit as children of God, we call to our Father, Abba, with our needs and the needs of our sisters and brothers.
For the church, that we might proclaim the good news in word and action, making disciples of all nations, let us pray to the Lord. For the leaders of our country, that they may lead this nation to embrace justice, kindness, and generosity for the benefit of all its people, especially those most vulnerable to injustice, intolerance, and economic exploitation. Let us pray to the Lord. That we may take action to heal our vulnerable environment, never taking for granted the wonders of God's creation as we care for our common home. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died defending our country, that they and their families may find comfort in God's loving arms, and that the sacrifice they made will never be forgotten. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us, having been baptized in the name of the Holy Trinity, in thanksgiving for being able to be called a child of God, one whom God has created, redeemed, and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. For the petitions in our basket, may be answered, let us pray to the Lord. For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Triune God, your goodness and love sustain us through our hardships and bring joy to our lives. Look upon us and our needs with your goodness and love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please turn to the song of the Revelation, yes, number 783, the Holy Holy Holy.
Thank you.
Let's serve you, Lord God, all creation, for through your design, the seed, the bread, and the wine, fruit of the earth, and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Let's serve you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and, giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." mystery of faith.
Thank you.
sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I
Take my life. This Saturday, there will be devotions to the Master of Mary at 9 o'clock in this church, followed by Bible study. A reminder to pick up your box of envelopes if you have not already. They are on the table for you. We need a couple of volunteers to dig a French drain. We had a structural engineer out here who was looking at our old church. Foundation stones of which were laid in 1874. We're trying to see if it's still worthy, structurally sound. But he just happened to come over to this church and he said, "Your drain system here, if you don't do something about this, you're going to crack the foundation." So we just need to dig like a little trench in the dirt that takes the water from where it's going down away from our foundation. And hopefully we've got some people here that can do that. Everyone is invited to enjoy refreshments in the East Wing after Mass today. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided union through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son.